We're living in a horsepower golden age, but while V8s get all the attention, hatchbacks are becoming hotter and more fun than ever. And two of the hottest are the Ford Focus RS and the Honda Civic Type R. But unlike V8s and supercars, hatchbacks need to work every day, and that's exactly how we've been testing these two on the streets of Metro Detroit. If you want the most powerful hot hatchback around, it has to be the Ford Focus. It has the biggest engine in the class, a 2.3-liter turbocharged four-cylinder with 350 horsepower and 350 pound-feet of torque. And that is a lot for a car this size. Helping you put all that power down is a standard all-wheel drive system, which is definitely something you won't get in the front-drive Civic. What I'm less crazy about is the 6-speed manual in the Focus RS, and I'm not saying that just because our test car happens to be an older example that's had 13,000 miles put on it. The gates are really hard to get into. You kind of have to strong arm it a little bit if you want to make your shifts. The clutch is much heavier and much more harder to modulate, and it simply doesn't feel as friendly as the transmission in the Honda. Focus RS has power and predictability in spades, making it a very, very enjoyable, quick car. But the Civic is more of a driver's car. Its 2-liter turbocharged four-cylinder pumps out 306 horsepower and 295 pound-feet of torque, which is less than the Focus, there's no denying that. But the Civic is also 300 pounds lighter. It always feels more urgent, it always feels more willing to go than the Focus, which you kind of have to prod with a stick. The Civic is very sharp, it's very focused in the way it handles, no pun intended. This is a very agile car. In fact, I think it might be the sharpest handling car for the money right now. It feels so good around turns, so predictable, so communicative, that all you want to do is drive it around your favorite stretch of road. This 6-speed manual transmission is classic Honda. It is light, it's easy to predict, it's easy to manage. The clutch pedal has a nice wide catch point that doesn't take a lot of effort to find, and each gate on this manual transmission is buttery, buttery smooth. And if you set it to the right mode, it rev matches for you. I spent the first 3 days of this test driving the Focus RS, and when the Civic Type R finally arrived, I sat down and it was kind of like falling into my favorite chair. These seats are so much more comfortable every day, and the ride is much, much better. This is just an easier vehicle to live with, but there are also practical benefits going with the Civic over the Ford. You get more rear seat legroom, and you get a bigger cargo hold. So with all those positives about the Honda, what does the Ford have going for it in everyday usability? Well, two words, heated seats. Here's two more words, a heated steering wheel. Now, if you live in the South or somewhere where it's perpetually warm and sunny, then you really don't care about those things. But for a northerner, for someone that doesn't see the sun for 6 months out of the year, it's a deal breaker. There's also more practical things. The Honda's rear hatch is bigger. There's more room back there, but it's also heavier. Sometimes it almost feels like you need two hands to open and close it. Not so in the Ford. Just grab the handle, fling it down. I know we're kind of grasping here because the reality is that in terms of everyday usability, the Ford simply isn't as good as the Honda. I love how much fun this car is. A lot of it is because of how it sounds. It pops and bangs, and when I first got out of this car, I had to walk around the back to make sure that it didn't have some kind of Ford aftermarket exhaust on it, because it's so loud and it's so in your face. Both of these cars are a lot of fun in the bends. Obviously, the Civic is more dynamically capable than the heavier Ford, which kind of sloshes about a little bit, but they're fun to throw around. But what separates them is that the Ford is much more fun in a straight line. You get this really obnoxious exhaust sound, and it's great. It bangs and it pops, and the power is there. It's just so effortless that you find yourself accelerating for no good reason at all. The Civic Type R feels like a very serious car. It's a car that wants to be going a certain way, and when it's not going that way, it's just not willing to have fun. It's not in the mood. Unless you're on a great winding piece of road, it feels kind of like a fast Civic. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's a good thing. But in terms of how it accelerates and how it behaves under a heavy throttle, the Focus is just more fun than this. There's a kind of surgical precision to the way that the Civic handles. It feels sharp and fun when presented with a good piece of road. And its thresholds feel higher than the Focus. You can push this car harder and harder and harder before it lets go. That's a lot of fun, even if it's not as good in a straight line. One of my favorite things about the Honda Civic Type R is the way it looks. It's not that it looks good. It doesn't look good. It's too busy. They didn't stop styling it. But the impact that its looks have on other people is really, really amusing. It's really funny. You drive past someone that doesn't know what it is, that thinks cars should look a certain way, and they kind of get this cat butt face where they snicker up their nose and they don't know what to think about it. It's kind of the same look that you would give a dog that's squatting on your favorite rug. This is not an attractive car, but the way that it makes people react is something that's really, really amusing. I haven't gotten tired of it in the entire time that I've been driving it. With these two cars, it really comes down to understanding their character. The Focus RS is a five-door muscle car. It's the way it behaves. It doesn't handle as well. It's quick in a straight line. The Civic Type R, this is a five-door sports car, and that makes it the better overall dynamic performer. If you want a grin-inducing automotive firecracker, you have to go with the Ford Focus RS. But if you need an everyday hatchback that's as comfortable commuting and going to Home Depot as it is tackling your favorite winding road or racetrack, you'll want the Honda Civic Type R. Until next time, I'm Brandon Turkus. For more on the Ford Focus RS and Honda Civic Type R, be sure to check out our full story on MotorOne.com.